when we come out here to do and show our people we are according to God, give you some knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Give me Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 1. Because we come out here with a message today. We come out here to, what's this, Watkins and Fraser Boulevard.
That's
to
right.
Give you a message, thus saith the Lord. Read what you got. Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 1. Read.
The book of Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 1. The Spirit of the Lord God.
The Spirit of the Lord God. The Spirit of God is this Bible. Read.
Yes,
it's right. Upon me. Uh-huh. Because the Lord have anointed me to preach good tidings unto me, to the meek. He have sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
A lot of people are brokenhearted out here. The Most High God sent us, the Israelites, every man out here that is in his purple and gold, to come out to you out here in Fraser Boulevard to bind up and to deliver you from the bondage that you serve. I read.
To proclaim liberty.
To proclaim liberty.
That's right.
God sent us out here to proclaim liberty out here.
That's right.
Who want to be free?
Bring it out.
All throughout the week, and you find no day of rest. But guess what? Today is the Lord's Sabbath day of rest. Did you know that?
That's right.
Bring it out. Keep reading.
To the captives.
To the captives. You were brought here on slave ships. Black man, you were brought here as captives. The Bible lets you know that. But guess what? When was the last time you picked up the Bible and read it? That's why we came out here. Read.
And the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
You are the ones that fill the prison houses in America. Down in 201 Poplar. You go down there, our people are in the prison houses. The Most High sent us to proclaim this good news to you. What is the good news? What is the good news, black man?
Yeah.
You looking for the good news? We got it. Give me that Romans. Alright? The good news. What's good, black man? You don't know. Guess what? Y'all call evil good. Read what you got. We're going to tell you what's good. Read. Yeah.
The book of Romans, chapter 7 and verse 12.
Bring it out.
Therefore, the law is holy,
uh-huh,
and the commandment holy,
uh-huh,
and just and good.
The Bible said that God's laws are good.
That's right.
All right, but y'all don't believe that.
That's right.
Y'all go to Isaiah chapter 5. All right, this is what y'all do, though, black man and black woman. Y'all call evil good. What happened? What happened to your understanding? What happened to your knowledge and understanding about God? Y'all call evil good. I guess how we know. But guess what? We got people back here selling the pig.
That's right.
All
right,
that's an evil abomination unto God. But guess what? You probably think it's good, though. I bet you think it's good. It looks good, don't it? It tastes good, don't it? But guess what? God said it's abomination.
That's when
I
right.
The pig, he said it's abomination unto you.
That's
you
not right.
Eat it. But I do it, okay? They're going to sell it to you. They're going to feed it to you. Read what you got.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 5 and verse 20.
Bring it out.
Woe unto them.
The Bible said, woe unto them. Read.
That call evil good.
That call evil good.
What?
Eating pork on the Lord's Sabbath day is evil.
That's right.
Buying and selling on the Lord's Sabbath day is evil.
That's right.
If you're working on the Lord's Sabbath day, it is evil. We just told you that the laws of God is good, but you despise God's laws.
That's right.
And guess what? You're going to be put to death.
Right.
Don't get mad at us. We come out here and warn you. Go to Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 1.
Yeah.
We come out here and warn you, men and black. We come out here to warn men, women, and all you children about the wrath of God.
That's
if you don't
right.
Repent in these last days. Right. At the party, y'all think it's a game. Y'all think that this Bible is a joke. Not knowing that God made each and every last one of y'all. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 58 and verse 1. Cry aloud.
That's why we out here. We out here cry aloud. And guess what?
Spare not.
The Bible tells us not to spare your feelings.
That's right.
We don't care how you feel.
That's right.
Y'all been feeling some type of way for a long time. And guess what? It got you nothing but trouble.
That's right.
You've been in nothing but trouble since you came over in America because of how you feel. You want to worship the other nations. You want to assimilate with other people.
Right.
But God made you a special people unto himself.
Right.
So when you going to come out of that sleep that you in? When you going to wake up? Breathe.
Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
The Most High God commanded us to come out here and lift up our voice like a trumpet. That's why we got the speakers. So you can hear us. Breathe.
And show my people.
He said, show my people. That means God got us. is. What sin are you in, black man?
Get out.
You breaking the Lord's Sabbath day. Did you know that? Go to Exodus chapter 20.
Get out.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 8. Because our people work on the Lord's Sabbath day. That shop should be closed today. The Sabbath is from Friday sundown to Saturday sundown. Yeah. You should not be working on the Lord's Sabbath day.
What?
You got 6 days to do it. You better get it in. Because if you settle on the Lord's Sabbath day when Christ comes back, you're going to be burned with nuclear fire.
That's right. The book of Exodus, chapter 20 and verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day.
The Bible said, remember the Sabbath day. Read.
To keep it holy.
It said to keep it holy. Do our people know the Lord's Sabbath day? How you doing, sir? Let me ask you a question. Do you know the Lord's Sabbath day? Read.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
The Bible says 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. Read. Chapter 2. He did that in the very beginning. The word Genesis means beginning. Alright? So read that. When he sanctified the Lord the Sabbath day, read.
The book of Genesis, chapter 2 and verse 2. And on the seventh day.
And on what day?
The seventh day.
No, Monday.
The seventh day.
No, Tuesday.
The seventh day.
Read.
His work, which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day.
Now, what did the Lord do?
Rested on the seventh day.
So if you be children of God, why are you working on this on the Sabbath? Why are you working on the Lord's Sabbath day? Because guess what? First of all, you don't know that you're breaking the Lord's Sabbath day.
Right.
Let's find out why you don't know. Go to Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah chapter 1.
Bring it out!
Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 3.
Teacher!
Read.
The book of Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner.
The Bible said an ox, a dumb animal, knows his owner. Read.
And the ass, his master's crib.
Y'all hear what God said? He said a donkey, an ass, knows his master's crib. He know where to go home. But check this out. Read.
Israel!
But these Israelites,
blacks,
Hispanic, and Native Americans, read,
does not know.
You don't know. You don't know. Read.
My people did not consider.
You don't even consider because you don't know. Right. You don't consider because you don't know. Go to Isaiah chapter 1.
Read up.
Hosea, go to Isaiah. You don't consider, black man. You don't consider that you're breaking the Lord's Sabbath day.
Right.
You've been doing it all your life, and you never consider that you might just be in sin. That's why the other nations come over here and they rule over you.
They take over
your communities because you have no God. You have departed yourself from your power.
Bring it out.
This is your God.
Don't worry about y'all.
Consider y'all way. Consider your way.
You have to pay attention to what? The word of God.
That's right.
The word of God. How y'all doing? Did you know you were Israelite according to the Bible? Listen to what the word of God say. Read.
The book of Haggai, chapter 1 and verse 5.
Bring it out!
Now therefore, thus saith the Lord of hosts.
Thus saith the Lord the host, read.
Consider your ways.
The Bible says consider your ways. Consider what you're doing today. Today is the Lord's Sabbath day. There should be no buying, no selling, no cooking, no working on the Lord's Sabbath day.
That's right.
A day of rest that the Most High sanctified for his people. Consider your ways, black man. Go to Exodus chapter 18 and verse 20.
Bring it out.
Y'all need to consider your ways. Consider your ways. Alright? You in the midst of sin and don't know it. Read.
The book of Exodus, chapter 18 and verse 20. And thou shalt teach them ordinances.
God gave the Bible to Moses to what? The word of God to Moses to tell the Israelites to do what?
and laws.
And what?
And laws.
There go that word again, God, laws.
That's right.
And shall show them the way wherein they must walk.
That said, the way in which they must walk. Alright? Because guess what? If you don't walk after God's laws, guess what you're walking after? You're walking after your own lust.
That's
your own
right.
flesh.
That's you know? Right.
Give me that. Okay, now. Galatians. Now, yeah, fine. You're walking after your own lust. Alright? So you gotta ask yourself, are you walking after the Spirit or are you walking after your own lust?
Chapter 5 and verse 19.
What are we reading? The Holy Bible.
That's right.
Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry.
Idolatry. A lot, we know a lot of y'all work the work of the flesh because guess what? Guess who you serve? You serve Caesar Borgia, your neighborhood friendly white guy. Churches, he's in all, as a matter of fact, he's in everybody's mind.
Bring it up.
Except for the ones that repented and came into their understanding of who God really is.
That's right.
Alright, so guess what the Bible say about that idolatry. Guess what you say you ain't. Go to Joshua 24 and verse 23. Guess what the Most High God say about your false idols. Yes, the white man is a false idol.
That's right.
Is a false idol. Listen to what the Bible say. Read.
The book of Joshua, chapter 24, and verse 23.
Read it up.
Now therefore, put away, said he.
Say who?
Said he.
Read.
The strange gods.
The what?
The strange gods.
The Bible calls this man a strange god because guess what? He's a stranger. He's of the other nations. He's not of the children of Israel.
That's right.
How you doing, young man?
Which are among you, and incline your heart unto the Lord of God of Israel.
It says, incline your heart to the Lord God of Israel. He's only the God of the Israelites.
That's right.
All right, give me that in the Lord Joel, 2:27. He's only the God of the Israelites. He only made a covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and nobody else. And who got a problem with it? Where you at? Who got a problem with God making a covenant with the children of Israel?
Bring it out!
Where you at? Where you so-called Christians at?
Bring it out.
We know y'all here because y'all gonna be the church come Sunday.
That's right.
But when you see the Israelites, you know, you ain't nowhere to be found. Why? The wicked flee with no man pursuer.
Bring it out.
That's why. Do what you got.
The book of Joel, chapter 2 and verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel.
The Bible said that you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel. Thus saith the Lord God.
Bring it out.
Now who got a problem with it?
Bring it out.
Because guess what? You can't stop God from doing what he want to do. Go to Psalms 1, finish it out.
And that I am the Lord, your God.
That he is the Lord your God.
And none else.
And nobody else's. And nobody else's. Go to Psalms 105. Alright? You made a covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob a long time ago, and it still stands to this very day.
Right.
And this covenant, his promises is in the Bible, is not to the other people. Alright? That's why we come out here for you guys.
Bring it up.
Made a cup. He only came for the Israelites. Matter of fact, go to Romans 9. We ain't gonna worry about that. He only came for the Israelites.
Bring it up.
All the promises and the covenants in the Bible is only for the Israelites.
That's right.
Did you know that? First of all, you gotta know that you're Israel. A lot of y'all still think you're black. Blacks. Black is just the color in the crayon box. But listen to what the Most High God said right here in Romans chapter 9 and verse 1.
The book of Romans chapter 9 and verse 1. I say in Christ, I lie not. My conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I can wish that myself were accursed from Christ. For
life. It's referring to. That's who you are. That's who you be.
Bro, I can't wait till one.
To whom pertaineth the adoption?
To whom pertaineth the adoption? That's Christ dying on the cross.
That's right.
We know. And the glory. And the covenant.
And the way.
And the covenant. See, the only covenant was only given to the Israelites. That's why we told y'all, if you think this ain't true, then come up here.
That's right.
The Most High God said, you've been, this Bible teaching you that you've been lied to your whole life.
Right.
Your pastor's not telling you the truth.
Right.
But we come out here to give you the understanding, the sense and knowledge of the Bible.
Bring it out, huh?
You've been lied to your whole life. How you doing, man? You know that they lied to you ever since you was a young man? Did you know we got the truth for you today? Hey, stop here 1 minute. Let me tell you something. Go to John chapter 8 and verse 32. Hey, look, man, the Most High put us here to come out here and tell our people who they are according to Him. If I ask you what's your nationality, what would you say?
Huh?
How do you know you're an Israelite? How do you know that? Yeah, how do you know? Alright, the Bible tells us, go to Romans chapter 8 and verse 16. Alright, first of all, we gotta know that God is a spirit, okay? Alright, we must worship Him in spirit. So He deal with us according to the spirit that's in His Bible. Alright, when you read John chapter 6 and verse 63, it tells you that the word of God is a spirit.
That's right.
Alright, so if you read this, read Romans 8 and 16.
The book of Romans chapter 8 and verse 16. The spirit itself.
So the spirit that's in this Bible, because this Bible got a spirit bearing witness with our spirit, who?
That we are the children of God.
So that we are the children of God. Alright, so go to Exodus 4:22, because I want you, what it means to be somebody's children means like a child means like a son, right? Alright, so God has a people that He considers it to be His son.
That's right.
Alright, so listen to this. Go to Exodus 4:22.
The book of Exodus, chapter 4, verse 22. And thou shalt say unto Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord, Israel is my son.
You hear that?
The Most High God said, Israel is my son. So when we came out here and we say we children of the Most High, He said, Israel is my son. Alright, so who are the Israelites? Alright, what were the Israelites doing during Pharaoh time? What were they doing? Yeah, they was in bondage. Alright, they was in slavery, captivity. Alright, so go to Exodus, go to Deuteronomy 28. So what you gotta understand is the Most High delivered the Israelites out of the hands of the captivity the first time, which was under Pharaoh. And He brought them into the wilderness and He told them, look, if you keep my commandments, then I will make you great above all people. But if you break my commandments, I'm gonna bring you back into slavery. Did you know that? We're gonna read that too. Go to Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15.
Bring it out.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So this is Moses speaking to the Israelites, telling them, if you won't listen to the voice of the Lord your God, the one that brought you out of slavery in Egypt, read.
To observe, to do all His commandments.
So if you don't do His commandments, because He's the one telling you what to do, read.
And His statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, Moses told the Israelites that all these curses, meaning evil things, gonna come over you and overtake you. I mean, you ain't nothing you can do. Ain't nothing you can do. He's come up here right now and overtake us. What can we do? We got overtake him. So these curses gonna overtake you.
That's right.
Go to verse 68.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Remember, that was in Egypt under slavery under Pharaoh. He said, I'm going to bring you into Egypt again, into slavery again. They proved that means slavery. Read that.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20 and verse 2.
No.
I am the Lord thy God.
You hear what God say? Read.
Which shall brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
Out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage. That proved that Israelite was in slavery the first time. Read now, go back.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Into slavery again, read.
With ships.
What a sign there. With ships. What a sign there, right here. Who this happened to, bro? You see this? our people, ain't it? That's us, ain't it?
Yeah.
That is. They were brought into slavery on the ship. They came to pass. Go back to 15. Listen to it again. Read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
It shall what?
It shall come to pass.
You see that? It shall come to pass. That's a curse, an evil thing. So that's how we know that we the Israelites.
That's right.
We came over here on slavery, on slave ships. God said it was going because of our disobedience. Alright? Because the people that came before us, guess what? They broke God's laws and those curses fell upon our people. Alright, go to Joshua verse 45.
Verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee.
Overtake thee again, all these curses that you think,
till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
That's right.
To keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and a wonder.
They shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder. That curse is still upon our people to this very day.
That's right.
That's how we know we the Israelites. Let's get some more curses. Go to verse 15.
Verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken. Verse 16. Cursed shall thou be in the city.
Who cursed in all the cities in America?
Bring it out,
in poverty. We are, right? So you see how the curses overtook us? No matter who we are, we try to move out there with the white folks, there, what they do, they move and be in another suburb and still leave you behind. Because guess what? Riley and our family, they do the white folks who stay out here.
That's right.
Wait, no, you know what I'm saying? But then they moved out and then they made all this and they said, you bet for it, y'all come stay here now. And they went over and got the good land. That's a curse. That's an evil thing. You see what I'm saying?
Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field.
Who was cursed in the fields? We were. That's how we know we the Israelites. You know, we know we the Israelites because we fit these curses.
That's right.
And it's been on us forever. It's been on us forever. We trying to get up out of it.
That's
so
right.
So we know that we the Israelites, and we went into slavery for disobedience. Guess what we got to do? We gotta come up, we gotta be obedient to the words of God. That's why you see, we used to be out here on the streets too, but guess what? We said, damn, we the Israelites, we in the slavery because we got wiser. We got wiser. We said, you know what, let's rise up. Let's change our actions. Let's change our way. Let's be men of the Most High.
That's right.
See, we are his children. See, that's the problem with our people that say they're a child of God. Everybody want to act like they good and this, that, and the other, but you ain't good unless you keep the God's laws. It is what it is.
That's right.
When you come out and get that understanding that you're a child of God and keep the commandment, you're good. Read what you got.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And now, Israel, what does the Lord thy God require of thee?
The Most High God is requiring every Israelite man something.
Read. That's right.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
You got to fear God. You gotta fear that, man. If I ain't keeping God's commandment, I walk on the street, somebody gonna knock my ass off. I'm just dead right there in the middle of the street. That's the only thing that's gonna make you fear, but make you do the laws of God.
That's
because
right.
Because if you go by your own understanding, you like, man, you know, I'm gonna get high, I'm gonna get drunk, I'm gonna hit that right there. You know what I'm saying? There ain't no fear, God. Because God said, don't do that.
That's right. That's right.
To walk in all his ways.
It said walk in all his ways. God ways it for us to be selling drugs to one another? You think God ways for us is to be putting out our sisters? When he made Adam and Eve and made the woman? You see what I'm saying? So he never gave us the understanding to be out here to run wild.
That's right.
Running wild. You know what I'm saying?
And to love him.
And to what?
Love him.
Let me ask you, man, how do we love God? By honoring him. You're right. But the Bible gives us a more detailed definition on how to do that. Get that for him. Look what the Bible says. It gives you, the Bible is this old dictionary. It breaks it down. So you don't have no excuse. When the Most High God stand in front of you, you ain't got no excuse. If you ain't been thought, you might as well just bow your head and get ready for the wrath of God. It is what it is.
That's right.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3. For this is the love of God.
So this is the love of God, read.
That we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous.
You ain't got no excuse. He said that we keep his commandments, and his commandments us are not grievous. Meaning what? What is grievous? No, it's not hard to do. Alright, we're going to read some of God's commandments. Give me number 15.
What you want?
Yeah, we read that. Well, we're going to read one of God's commandments. Read that.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11 and verse 4. Verse 1. Be ye followers of me, even as I am of Christ.
Alright, Christ is the Son of God. This was Paul saying, be ye followers of me as I am of Christ. All that Christ and the Most High, they agree. Alright? So everybody said, be you following me as I am of Christ. Read.
Now I praise you, brethren, that you remember me in all things and keep the ordinances.
There's an order. He said, yeah, this is a commandment. So this is a commandment. It's an order. Read.
As I delivered them to you, but I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So our head is above us. Order, like, you know, like at work, you got your boss, he's ahead of you, he's over you, alright? So this is the order that the Most High God has established for the man, read.
The head of every man is Christ.
Christ is our head, right, because he died for us, and God made him Lord over us, read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of every woman is a man.
That's right.
That's our rightful duty right there.
That's right.
And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ, our Lord, is God.
Every man, praying or prophesying, having his head covered, this honor of his head.
So who is your head? There you go, Christ. So we know that too. So we came into the commandment, we start to understand, so this is what you see. On our head, we ain't got what on. We ain't got nothing covering our head. Because when we do that, we honor. Remember you said honor? So you honor God by keeping his commandment. When the commandment was that when anybody praying, so when you pray or you prophesy, that's what we're doing now. We prophesying about the Israelites waking up. We're prophesying about the destruction of America.
That's right.
We're prophesying. So anybody doing that, we don't.
But every woman, every man that prophesied with his head covered, dishonor his head.
So when you're doing that, you dishonor your head, which is Christ. So what do you think you gotta do?
And when you do so, what are you doing?
There you go.
That's right.
So what you gonna do?
Well, if you in the midst of prophecy, what we doing right now? Take it out. So it's what it do, brother. Show it. Thank you. So what it do is show the sign of respect. Because guess what? When you walk into the courtroom and they got the order set up, they say, you know, you come in there, we're going to try to turn your phones off. Everybody do it, right? They show respect. All the Most High want to do is just see the respect.
That's right? Right.
You see the Bible coming out, you walk amongst it, walk up on it, go to Exodus 5 and 1. You walk up under the understanding of his word, you do respect. Take your head off.
You be humble, you listen to the word of God.
Listen, because listen here, read.
The book of Exodus, chapter 5 and verse...
No.
Ecclesiastes 5 and 1.
Yeah. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 5 and verse 1. Keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of God.
Whenever this Bible is coming out, God is commanded to keep thy foot. Means stand still.
And be more ready to hear.
And be more ready to hear the word of God. Because we're just talking. But really, we just reading the word that's on the Bible, so God is the one who wants you to hear.
That's but right.
It ain't me, you know what I'm saying? It's God that wants you to hear. Read.
Then to give the sacrifice of food.
Because God is all-knowing God. He knows what's good for you. So he wants he said, instead of you opening up and then just rambling off, he wants you just to listen. Read.
For they consider not that they do evil.
Because the Most High said we consider that we don't
that's
do evil.
Right.
Be not rash with thy mouth.
Don't be rash with your mouth. Read.
And let not thine heart be hasty to utter anything before God.
Yeah, before God. You know, like we're telling you, God is a spirit. He's this Bible right here. So don't be so quick to utter anything. You've been real good with that. But go to Proverbs chapter 2. Because that's what we come out here to do, man. We come out here to deliver the word of God. And we ain't out here trying to sell you a CD or nothing like that. Be like, bro, come on, listen to my rap song. We out here, man, with the word of God, just to say, bro, you know, we the Israelites, keep God's commandments.
That's right.
Before Christ comes back, because he's our head, and he's going to make him ruler over the whole world. You know what I'm saying? You got to believe that thing, but guess what? It starts with the fear of God. You know what I'm saying? And you considering your ways, whether they be evil or they be good according to God.
That's right.
Because he made you. That makes sense? All right. Read that.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 2, verse 1. My son.
You know what God called you? He called you my son. Meaning you a child of God. Because your spirit bear witness with what? With this Bible that read about the slave ship, remember? So you a child of God, right?
If thou wilt receive my word.
If God said, if you receive his words, you got a Bible? That's his word. If you put a good Bible, that's God's word. If you will receive his word, read.
And hide my commandments with thee.
And hide with your commandments, what we tell you to do with you, read.
So that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom.
And you incline your ear unto wisdom, you become wise, read.
And apply thine heart to understanding.
Read that again.
And apply.
Meaning do.
That's right.
You took that out. You do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yea, if thou criest after knowledge and lift up thy voice for understanding.
If you cry after knowledge and lift up thy voice for understanding to who? To God. Read.
If thou seekest her as silver and searchest for her as for him.
If somebody gave you a map right now and told you there's a pot of silver and gold hidden up somewhere right there, you would spend all day looking for it? They say, man, for sure, we know it's out there. You gotta go out there and get you a shovel and go look for it. They told you how much it was, over $10 million, I bet you go look for it. God said, look, if you take that amount of effort like that and apply it to the world, he said you're gonna be all
right. That's right.
Then shalt thou understand the spirit of the Lord.
It said, then you're gonna understand the fear of the Lord.
That's right.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.